They walked through a glorious meadow full of flowers and butterflies. Across the meadow, they saw a unicorn basking in the warm sun. They approached him and spoke.
"Excuse me," asked Alice. "Can you tell us where to find Queen Caribou?"
"Oh, damn, not again."
The hero somehow knew that the only way to get a unicorn to do what he wanted was to partake in some serious coddling.
"But Charlie, we're going to Candy Mountain, Charlie. Wake up, Charlie. Candy Mountain, Charlie."
"No."
"But Charlie."
"Okay, fine. I'll take you to Candy Mountain. But I better not lose a kidney this time."
"Okay, Charlie."
And so they marched up Candy Mountain. At the top of the mountain, they found a great candy cave.
"This must be where Queen Caribou lives,"
observed Alice.
"Screw this. Bye."
"What do we do now?" asked Agenda.
"We go find Queen Caribou."
"Can you see a rat trap right here?"
came a voice from behind them.
No,
said Alice.
"Who are you?"
"I am Queen Caribou."
"Oh, hello. Can you help get my cell phone out of the moose?"
"Oh, no,"
she said.
"But first, I have to say my magical Queen Caribou word." "Maverick, lipstick, law and order. Skiing, snow, maritime border. If I was elected to the office of Vice President of the United States, I would..."
"What would you do?"
"A thing, a thing, a puppy dog. Turn this chair into a frog."
Then, wonder of wonders, the cell phone appeared in Phallus's hand.
"My cell phone!" she observed.
"Martin!" cried Hydrangea.
"Wait a minute. Is that a snow white charm on your cell phone?"
"I have a snow white charm on my phone. The last time I saw it was when I was giving it to my daughter. I had to give her up for adoption, you know, since I was, you know, socially precarious because I wasn't married."
"Mommy?"
asked Phallus.
"Phallus, is that you? Oh, Phallus, it's been so long since I've held you in my hand."
"That's what she said."
"I am so sorry I left you because I wanted to advance politically."
"It's okay, Mother. I, too, want to advance politically."
"Like mother, like daughter."
"And who is this strapping young lad?"
"Martin the Moose."
"Who? Hydrangea?"
"You have led my daughter to me. How can I repay you for your bravery?"
"Can I have some money?"
"No."
"Can I have some corn?"
"Your friend's out of corn."
"Can I have a duck?"
"We only have lame duck."
"Well, then,
What kind of craze are you? You're supposed to ask for her hand, you know."
"But I don't want her hand. I got two of my own."
"In marriage."
"In marriage?"
"I don't want what happened to me to happen to you, Phallus. You don't find a nice young man like that of your dynasty."
"Well, all right. I guess we can get some good tax benefits out of it."
Then there was a puff of smoke and Prince Slipper appeared. "Better late than never."
"Hold up a minute. We are betrothed, woman," cried Slipper.
"How did you get here?"
"I've been watching you."
"Okay."
"Creeper."
"I've been following your status updates on Facebook."
"Oh, that makes sense."
"Hold on there, you young whippersnapper."
"I've always had a thing for women in glasses."
"Oh, really?"
"Really."
"Well, I've always had a thing for younger men."
"Much younger men."
"Well, I have no problem with that."
"And we'd probably get some good tax benefits out of it."
And they all lived happily ever after. The hook and gosh! And the moral of the story is,
if you give a moose a cell phone, he's gonna want some magic to go with it.